For so long I was silent. For so long I did not have a song of praise. Depression filled my days and clouds blocked my way. But there was a voice speaking to me.
I'm here with the beautiful and the anointed Pastor Yolanda Morgan. We're located, we're doing the interview at the Celebration of Life Church. Thank you. And Pastor Morgan has a beautiful, beautiful testimony to share. I was able to sit in on a Sunday morning worship service, and I heard this woman of God open up her heart and share her testimony. Pastor Morgan, thank you so much for coming to the Lois Banks Show.
Thank you for inviting me. It's a pleasure.
Amen. Now, Pastor Morgan, I know the anointing of deliverance, and I know that it rests inside of you. You opened up your heart and you shared a very, very powerful healing testimony. But before we talk about that, can you open up your heart and talk about how you were first introduced to the Word of God?
Well, actually, I was raised in it all my life. My mom and dad were not in the ministry, but they lived a very, very strong Christian life. And they would take me to church, and never known anything else. I started probably when I was about 2 years old, knowing Christ, and then raised in a Christian home, and then started my life with the Lord probably around 10, probably got the baptism of the Holy Ghost around 10 years old.
Okay.
And then I was leading a choir at 15 years old.
Wow.
In my home church.
Okay.
And so just really have known nothing else but serving God. Love Him. Oh, my Lord, I love Him with everything that's within me.
Wow. So open up your heart and talk about how God was communicating with you as a young child. Because I'm always curious about God communicating and talking to the youth.
Yes. Well, again, I started very young. At 15 years old, I was leading our church choir, and then leading choirs at conventions.
Okay.
And but always had such a strong, strong desire to serve God.
Okay.
And wanted to be a minister. Always wanted to be a minister.
Okay.
I did. I had such a heart to serve God and want to begin the work of the ministry.
Okay.
And so I started praying at very young for God to send me a godly man.
Okay.
That loved God as much as I did.
Amen.
And so the Bible says to delight yourself in Him, and He will give you the desires of your heart. And so that's exactly what I did. We got married when I was only 18 years old.
Amen.
And I started off very young. Then we evangelized for 6.5 years.
Okay.
And then we took our first church to pastor in New Orleans, Louisiana, in 1975.
Okay.
And but just always, I've just had a heart to serve God. You know, where there has been, and I'm not saying that I was a perfect young person, but you know, you see children or young people that have other desires to venture out maybe in drugs and alcohol and do other things that are not pleasing to God.
Yeah.
My desire was, and God just instilled that in me.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, thank God for godly parents.
Yes.
But always had that desire to do something for the kingdom of God and to love Him with everything that was in me. And I just didn't want anything else in life but that.
Right.
Just, I wanted to serve Him.
Now, could you hear the voice of God audibly when you were a young girl?
Yes, I could.
Okay.
There were times, not a lot, but there were times that God spoke to me, yes.
Yeah.
And things that I was maybe would have led me another direction. God would always speak to me and say, I have my hand on you.
Yes.
You know, my desire is for you to go this direction.
Yes.
I have this goal and this purpose for your life.
Amen.
And so, yes, He did speak to me at a young person.
So you knew at an early age that God was real.
Absolutely.
No doubt in your mind.
No doubt in my mind.
Amen, amen. Now, so you're hearing the voice of God. You're obeying His voice. You stepped out of ministry, and what type of things were you dealing with as far as adversity when you stepped out by faith obeying God? Did you have to deal with any kind of adversity in the realm of the spirit?
Not really, because, you know, of course, we always have these battles that we have to fight. You know, we've always got something that, that the enemy wants to throw at us and maybe divert us from, you know, our plan or our goal or destiny. Those kind of things. Mm-hmm. But as far as, I just was determined.
Okay.
You know, I was not easily persuaded to turn away from what God had for me. You know, I just knew my purpose and my destiny was in God. And, you know, where a lot of people are drawn away by peer pressure and trying to be a people pleaser, I wanted to be a God pleaser.
Amen.
You know, I just wanted to be that. And so keeping my focus and serving God, I think that is what kept me from, you know, being discouraged or let some other things of the world or the enemy try to persuade me of anything else.
Amen. And the reason why I'm asking you that question, because there has to be something on the inside of you to help you stand on the Word of God.
Absolutely.
And to help you just lock in on the promises of God. There has to be something on the inside. Now, will you open up your heart and talk about the healing miracle that, that God gave you?
I will. Of course, I went, we were getting ready for a conference. The Lord spoke to me about having a women's conference here in the church.
Mm-hmm.
And we had started, we called them Glory, the Glories in the House conference. And so we had been preparing for that conference.
Okay.
And about a month prior to that, I started feeling very dizzy, vertigo.
Okay.
And
so you had some symptoms?
Yes, I did. Just did not feel well, just weak in my body. And so I would try to get, I went to a doctor, and the doctor told me that I had a sinus problem going on. He gave me an antibiotic.
Okay.
And I started taking that, but it was not getting any better.
Okay.
And so the ladies were preparing for the conference.
Mm-hmm.
And I would try to get up and prepare myself to take a shower. I would take the shower and have to go lay right back down because I had just no energy and my head was spinning. And
was God talking to you? Did he say what was going on or was he silent?
It was everything was during this time.
Okay.
And it was like, I'm asking God, where are you?
Mm-hmm.
What is this going on? You know, what's happening to me? All these questions.
Right.
And I make this statement, you know, some people do not understand, but I felt like God was on God on vacation, that he'd forgotten that I was even on this earth.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure you can relate to that.
A lot
of people can.
Yeah.
But as I was preparing for the conference, I remember coming, but I don't remember what actually went on during the conference. I can't remember what happened during the services, and we had refreshments and for the guests afterwards, and I don't even remember what happened, how I even got there.
Yeah.
And so after the conference was over, we had a special guest that came to the house on a Sunday evening.
Okay.
And I was sitting there, and my head began to hurt really, really bad. And I told my husband, I said, I have to go lay down. I'm very sick. And so I went to go lay down. They left later on that night. And I told my husband, I said, something is not right with me. We were prepared to leave the next morning to go to Florida. And so I told him, I said, I don't know if I can make the trip. But he said, after we get there, we're going to Daytona. He said, after we get there, you'll feel better.
Okay.
I remember how sick I was going. And as we got there, we got there about 3 o'clock the next morning. We were in this home, and in the bathroom, there were just mirrors everywhere. And I got up to go take a shower. And when I did, I looked in the mirror, and I was doubled.
Okay.
My eyesight had doubled. And I knew I was very, very sick. And so a friend of ours, they took me back to the hospital there in Daytona. And the doctor said, again, you know, I feel like you just have a real bad sinus infection. Just go take your antibiotics.
We misdiagnosed.
So anyway, after the week was over with, we went home. And my daughter-in-law came to my bed the next morning. And my right eye was turned. They rushed me to the hospital. Mm-hmm. And make a long story short, they thought at first maybe I might have had a stroke.
Okay.
And then they thought I had a grandma, what they call grandma headache.
Yes, a nurse.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So from that day, I stayed in Skyline Hospital mm-hmm. for a week.
Okay.
Then they transferred me to Vanderbilt Hospital mm-hmm. here. I stayed in the hospital for 27 days.
Wow.
I had 5 MRIs, mm-hmm. 5 spinal taps, okay. and 11 IVs in my arm.
Okay.
I lost right at 17 pounds. Mm-hmm. I was so sick, okay. so sick. And so they sent me home.
Okay.
And 3 days after that, they put me back in the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
Come home one more time. They sent me back home. Then I had optic neuritis.
Okay.
They sent me to an MS doctor and told mm-hmm. me I had MS.
Okay.
And told me that I needed steroid shots.
Okay.
And I said, no, I'm not going to do that.
Okay.
I went to a health doctor.
Okay. A naturopathic?
Yes.
Okay.
And I walked in there. He didn't believe in the Lord.
Okay.
And but I walked in there and I told mm-hmm. him, I said, sir, I know you don't believe in God.
Mm-hmm.
But I believe that God orders the steps of righteous people.
Amen.
And God ordered my steps to you.
Amen.
And with the power that you have in knowledge
yes.
and the power of God that resides
yes.
in me,
Amen.
I'm going to be totally healed.
Amen.
And he kind of looked at me and said, okay. But I knew he didn't understand what was coming out of my mouth. But I want you to know in 3 months,
mm-hmm.
3 months,
yeah.
the lesions were gone out of
Amen.
My brain.
Amen.
3 months. And my MS doctor looked at me and he said, I've got to release you.
Amen.
He said, there's no need in you coming back.
Amen.
That was the third year.
Amen.
The third year. And I want to tell you that God spoke to me and
yes.
he said, three means divine manifestation.
Amen.
And that's what God did in my
Amen.
Life. His Bless manifestation God. Was totally opened up, revealed in my life.
Amen.
In 3 years.
Amen.
And the doctors were amazed by it.
Amen.
I went back to see my doctor, and he just stood there and looked at me and says, I can't believe you're saying that.
Amen. Amen. Well, I'm so glad you opened up your heart and shared that testimony. I'm a licensed nurse by trade.
Are you really?
But I specialize in natural health. I teach
wow.
the body of Christ in the world how to combine the natural laws and the supernatural laws together for wholeness. I even wrote a children's book so that I can help the terminally ill. And I'm currently a senior in college, pursuing a Bachelor of Science degree as a health administrator. One of my mandates from God is to build a hospital and combine traditional holistic medicine, wean people off of medication, and teach them how to bring healing to the body, how to put the right nutrients inside.
And that's so important.
Yes. Please open up your heart and talk about the things that you put inside your body to minister health and healing alongside prayer and the Word of God.
Well, you know, I never went to bed, not one night,
yeah.
until I say these. And still today, I say this. I thank you, God,
yeah.
for my healing.
Yes.
But the nights that I would lay there in my bed and I would look up at the ceiling, I have a medallion over my bed,
mm-hmm.
and I would see the double vision, and
mm-hmm.
I wouldn't ask God, because you know, 2,000 years ago he bore all the stripes that we
yes.
were already healed.
Yes.
So I wasn't asking him for my healing because
yes.
I knew that was done.
Exactly.
I'm thanking for the manifestation
Amen.
That he had to do in my
Amen.
In my life. And so, oh my word, when I realized that I had to do something on my part.
Yes.
That I couldn't just say, God, you heal me.
Amen.
And not change my way of eating.
Exactly.
Or, you know, there's people that have high blood pressure
mm-hmm.
and they're standing in healing lines.
Yes.
And they don't want to change their way of life.
Amen.
And so I told God, I said, God, you tell me what to do along with this doctor and I will do it.
Amen.
And through the power of prayer, the healing virtue of Almighty God,
yes.
and me discipline my life,
Amen.
Because I was a junkie. I wanted to eat everything.
Okay.
And the doctor put me on a 7-day detox.
Amen.
And I tell you one thing, I thought I was near dying.
I know.
But
I know.
At the 7th day,
mm-hmm.
I felt like I could conquer the world.
That's
because
right.
all that stuff was out
the
of
junk
me.
Was coming out. Yeah.
And I can't tell you how much better I felt after
Amen.
7 days.
Amen.
But I changed my whole way of eating. still mm-hmm. to this day, mm-hmm. I try to stay off of sugar.
Yes.
You know, here's the thing. We look at human beings mm-hmm. and we think that they're different from vehicles. You got a gasoline motor
yes.
and you go put diesel in it, that yes. thing is not going to run. It's going to shut down.
Exactly.
And so we're putting the right nutrients in yes. our body.
Amen.
And we are protecting our body.
Amen.
And putting healing foods in our body. Amen. We're going to be healed.
That's right. Now, do you teach the knowledge that God has blessed you with here at Celebration of Church?
I do. Okay. I do. I don't do enough. I don't do enough of it, but I have. We actually have started a ministry here called mm-hmm. Extreme Makeover.
Okay.
Because the Lord spoke to me and mm-hmm. said the healing begins from the inside out.
Yes.
And so He took me to James
Amen.
1 when He Amen. Says that a man goes before a natural mirror
Amen.
And he sees himself.
Mm-hmm.
He sees all these things that need to be healed
yes.
and all these things that needs to be fixed, all
yes.
the flaws.
Yes.
But when he turns away from that mirror, he forgets what he
exactly.
saw.
Exactly.
And so what I think God is doing to the body of Christ,
mm-hmm.
not only does he want to heal us physically,
right.
but he wants to heal us spiritually.
Exactly.
And so I believe that if we can get this inner man healed,
mm-hmm.
I believe that the outer man, our physical body will be healed, because there's a lot of people walking around with a lot of stuff inside,
yeah. Yeah.
you know, with the past.
Yeah.
You know, all against somebody that spoke over their life in the past,
mm-hmm.
they can't get past it. But you can't go in your future staying in your past.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do that. So all of this goes together, mm-hmm. I believe, when you're talking about healing, this inner healing,
yes.
and then a physical healing.
Amen. Now, do you move in prophetic gifts, or are you in the office of a prophet?
I do some. I do
okay.
some. Yes, I do
that.
Oh, yes, I
okay.
do.
Okay.
Most definitely. Yes, I do. I don't do it often, but when
mm-hmm.
I feel it, girl, when I know when it's the Spirit
mm-hmm.
of God
okay.
up on my life and I speak it
Amen.
Comes to pass.
Amen.
Yes.
Now, do you consume organic foods?
Yes, ma'am.
Amen, because
mm-hmm.
I just saw that written across the forehead.
Uh-huh.
Organic.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Amen. Talk about the importance of eating clean foods that are not laced with chemicals.
Well, you know, that's, again, you know, we go back to the chemicals that are inside are all the food. We just
mm-hmm.
we're putting them right into our body.
Mm-hmm.
And I was hurting in my arms and my hands.
Okay.
When I got the chemicals out of my body,
yeah.
I quit hurting in my
Amen.
Arms and my hands.
Amen.
And so people don't realize that when you're eating organic foods,
yeah.
it's not sprayed with the chemicals that normally people
exactly.
spray them with. And then another thing, that it doesn't have the antibiotics in it
yes.
are the other things that they feed the cattles and the chickens.
Mm-hmm.
The story, you've probably heard it, but what amazes me is that they can take an egg
mm-hmm.
that a chicken hatches
mm-hmm.
from, and that normally it takes a bitty when it's birthed.
Mm-hmm.
It takes a year for that chicken to be full grown.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
They can take a chicken when they shoot them up with all of
and
these,
see the time.
6 weeks.
I know. Crazy.
6 weeks.
Crazy.
And they say that the body, actually the bones in the legs
mm-hmm.
of chickens
mm-hmm.
cannot hold up the body because the bones are so brittle because it doesn't have the nutrients in it.
Now, have you noticed, because I noticed, when I made that shift and began to detox and cleanse my body out, the liver, kidney flush, gallbladder flush, colon cleanse.
Oh, yeah.
I've been to parasite cleanse.
Yes, ma'am.
I went inside and started to clean my physical body
mm-hmm.
out. I noticed a shift in the spirit because now
yes.
on the inside I'm clean. There's no darkness. And that anointing just rests so heavy.
You're so right.
On the inside. Have you noticed
the
same
thing? Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Well, you know, it talks about it, the Word of God is first the natural and then the spiritual.
Yes.
And if people could just get their physical body in
yes.
line, because
yes.
it takes discipline.
It does.
And when you discipline this physical body, it automatically flows into the spiritual.
Yes.
Because a lot of people don't want to pray, they don't want to read their Bible, they don't
mm-hmm.
want to, you know, discipline themselves to do what God has called them to
yes.
do. You get that physical body in line.
Yes.
Then it just flows onto the spiritual. And you don't have to make yourself pray.
Exactly.
You don't have to make yourself read the Word of God. You don't have to make yourself go out and tell somebody look what God has done. It just flows out of you.
Yes.
It just flows out of you.
Yes. Amen. You know, when I'm working with my patients who are very, very sick, before they could reach that part where they can make a dietary change,
right.
I always tell my patients to get their Bible out if they're believers,
mm-hmm.
and to look in the back of the concordance underneath the heading for healing.
Yes.
And to find some scriptures that ministers to their heart, and to meditate in those healing scriptures and take it like a prescription,
mm-hmm.
and build the body back up so that it's strong enough in the natural to make those dietary changes with the fork. And every time, God has always been so faithful. I mean, people who are just like really sick and diseased. Can you talk about the healing power of God's word and how you can take it in like medicine and witness miracles in the body?
Well, you know, when I was so sick, my husband, he finally would leave me on a Sunday morning when I was at home because I could go to church.
Mm-hmm.
And he would finally leave me on a Sunday morning, and I was lying there in my bed. And he always said, because I had such vertigo,
mm-hmm.
that I would fall if someone wasn't assisting me.
And vertigo, to the people who don't understand, means?
And my head was just spinning all the time.
Exactly.
I was just dizzy, dizzy, dizzy.
Yes.
You know, and would almost fall over.
Yes.
And so he told me, he said, do not, because we have a two-story home.
Mm-hmm.
He said, do not go down the steps, he said, till I come back.
Okay.
And I was lying in my bed that morning. And there was a minister that actually came on TV, and
mm-hmm.
he said, I see you lying in that bed.
Okay.
And he said, I have a word for you. He
mm-hmm.
said, you have to go get your Bible.
Yeah.
And so I thought, oh, my word. Here's my husband telling me not to go downstairs because our office is downstairs.
Mm-hmm.
And so I actually crawled down the stairs because I didn't want to fall,
mm-hmm.
and went and got in my Bible. And he took me to Jeremiah 17:7
mm-hmm.
because I thought that it was going to be a scripture of healing.
Okay.
You know, because that's normally what people do, just like
mm-hmm.
you said.
Mm-hmm.
And so I said, okay, God, this is a verse that I can hang on to.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to heal me, and
mm-hmm.
I know that it is.
Mm-hmm.
And so I went and got my Bible, and I opened it up, and I read Jeremiah 17:7,
mm-hmm.
and it says this. It says, blessed
mm-hmm.
is the man
mm-hmm.
that trusts in the Lord.
Yes.
And he said that his leaves will not wither
yes.
when the winter comes.
Mm-hmm.
And I thought, okay, that's not a healing scripture. I
right.
want to be totally healed.
Yeah.
And when the Lord spoke to me, he said, but you will be healed
mm-hmm.
when you trust in me.
Amen.
And so when mm-hmm. I couldn't understand that until
mm-hmm.
I started my journey in the process that I was walking through.
Okay.
And when I knew that I could not receive healing,
mm-hmm.
I could not receive what God had for me because all I could see what was diagnosed.
Mm-hmm.
But when I looked at the God
all right.
and looked at what all he could do for me,
yes.
but I had realized I had to trust him
yes.
to get to the end of my process for him to heal me.
Amen.
You understand what
yes,
I'm saying?
I do.
And I don't have anything because there's scriptures on the word of God. He was wounded for our transgression
yes.
and healed for our iniquity.
Yeah.
And all that is wonderful. But my journey through my process
mm-hmm.
is I had, even though I was raised in church
mm-hmm.
and knew the power of God,
yeah.
I had to renew my trust in him.
Yeah.
That it didn't matter how many times they diagnosed me with a dreadful disease.
Mm-hmm.
I had to realize
yeah.
that God was
yeah.
the one that I had to trust
yeah.
for him
yeah.
to give me my total healing.
Mm-hmm.
From the top of my head to the sole of my feet.
Mm-hmm.
Mentally,
mm-hmm.
physically,
yeah.
spiritually,
yeah.
all that. A whole person I had to become.
Amen. What a beautiful testimony. Thank you so much for opening up your heart and sharing. Now, I'm a mother of four.
Mm-hmm.
And I know you're a mother of three.
Yes.
Okay. And you've had some challenges. I've had some challenges.
Oh, yes.
Raising our children. I just interviewed your son.
Did you?
Pastor Wes Morgan. Can you open up your heart and encourage mothers who are going through some challenging times with their children and they're believing God for their
Absolutely.
Children's future?
Absolutely. The power of of being strong and standing. I was telling someone today that if you do not stand for your child, if you do not stand in the gap for that child and love him unconditionally, mm-hmm. that no one else is going to do that. Mm-hmm. And that's where I had to, when I carried our children mm-hmm. in my womb for 9 months, that's where I took my child and I carried him spiritually for 9 months. Mm-hmm. There is no way that son is going to come along and get where he needs to be in God. If you believe God one day mm-hmm. and then you go put him on the shelf and say, okay, God, you know, I forgot about him a couple more days. You mm-hmm. have to carry that child mm-hmm. 9 months and mm-hmm. realize that there's a burden that's going to come out of you carrying that child.
Yeah.
You can't let up. Amen. You cannot back up. Amen. You cannot let the enemy tell you that he's a has-been.
Amen.
You've got to say, this is my seed.
Yes.
This is my child.
Yes.
And I am determined to see deliverance in his life.
Amen.
I will not back up. I will not doubt because God said that he would save
yes.
our seed.
Amen.
And that's where we have to become. I would never give up on Wes.
Amen.
Never give up on Wes because I knew that God promised us
Amen.
Deliverance in his life.
Amen.
You can't do it. As a mother, you cannot do it. You have to stand firm and believe steadfast
Amen.
And believe that God's going to do it no matter what.
So you didn't give up on your healing?
No, ma'am.
You didn't give up on your child?
No, ma'am.
And that's what we need to
yes.
see
yes.
in the body of Christ.
Yes.
We do not give up
Mm-mm.
on the promises of God.
No, ma'am. Well, you know, it says, it is in his word, it says that there is no way that you can please God without faith.
Amen.
It's impossible to please God without faith.
Amen.
And when you think about it, you want to please God and bring him glory and honor,
Amen.
You've got to have faith. You are nothing without faith.
Amen.
And we are just empty vessels if we don't have faith. That's why Abraham, oh my word, he said he staggered not at the promises of God. And so we have all these promises. Why do we fret and why do we worry when we are in his hands and he
Amen.
Promised us those gifts and those
Amen.
Promises? We have to stand firm and say, okay, God, you said it.
Yes.
Your word does not lie.
Amen.
And I'm standing on your word and declaring it's going to happen.
Amen. Well, you're such a blessing to the Lois Banks Show. I'm so honored to be in your presence. I want to definitely continue to monitor your ministry, you and your husband's ministry,
yes.
Pastor Joseph.
Yes, absolutely.
Amen.
Absolutely. And I have a book coming out to hell and back,
Amen.
And we'll let you know about
yes,
that.
Well,
it's my testimony. It's
okay.
my testimony about the children,
mm-hmm.
and it is the title is To Hell and Back
Amen.
Because you know there's times when you feel like, oh dear God, I have gone to hell because
yes.
it's. It's torture thinking about your children.
Adversity.
Yes, 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 yes. But it'll give my testimony in the book, and it'll talk about when I started as a child.
Okay.
Because a lot of people ask me, because your child was on alcohol,
mm-hmm.
drugs,
mm-hmm.
you know, did you have to face that? I didn't. I was mm-hmm. raised in a Christian home.
Mm-hmm.
So I start when I was a child, and
mm-hmm.
I talk about my mom and dad
yeah.
and my heritage.
Yeah.
And then I bring it on down, and I talk about the end results. In Wes's life. So
Amen.
it's worth reading.
Yeah.
It definitely is worth reading.
Don't we serve a faithful God?
Oh,
good God.
Jesus.
Wow.
Yes, yes.
Hey,
yes.
Glory to God.
Yes, a faithful God.
A faithful God.
Amen.
Thank you so much, Pastor Morgan, for coming to the Lois Banks Show. You've been such a blessing. Thank you for opening up your heart and giving us some key insights. Yes, I hope, Lord.
For so long I was silent. For so long I did not have a song of praise. Depression filled my days and clouds blocked my way. But there was a voice speaking to me, awaking the passion so quiet in me. So still in me.
I choose to worship.
I can't lay here and give up, no. I choose to worship right now.